test and debug a GUI component. Now it's time to test whether the component is working as expected. Embedded Wizard implements for this purpose the so-called prototyper, a kind of virtual machine, a simulator, which is able to instantly interpret and execute the GUI application. So there's no need to start an external compiler and load the resulting binary to the target system. Let's try it out. In the upper area of Embedded Wizard window, click on the tool button Start Prototyper to test the actually edited GUI component. You can also use the shortcut F5 on your keyboard to achieve the same effect. As you can see, the Prototyper window appears. Within this window, you can play around with the GUI component. For example, you can click and drag on the horizontal slider. As you see, the GUI component works as the appearance of the slider changes accordingly to your actions. Now, try to click on the round play button in the bottom area of the test GUI component window. Nothing happens, right? This is because we started the prototyper directly with the component. You can imagine the component was running outside the remaining application. This test mode is thus ideal if you intend to test the component insulated from other parts of your application. Now let's close the prototyper window. Let's go to the upper area of the Embedded Wizard window and click on the tool button Start Prototyper with Application class. This is the way to test the entire GUI application and not only the actually edited component. You can also use the shortcut Ctrl F5 on your keyboard to achieve the same effect. In the just opened prototyper window, play with the application. In particular, try to click again on the round play button. Now the prototyper is loaded with the entire GUI application. Accordingly, pressing the play button has an effect as well. It starts the brewing process. You see a new GUI component overlapping the component in the background. The new component displays a round progress bar enclosed inside an image of an outlined coffee cup. When the brewing process is done, the overlapping component disappears automatically and the visual state of the underlying selection dialog component is restored. Every time you activate the push button, this operation repeats. Now, close the prototyper window again. As you have noticed, activating the push button causes a new component to be displayed. How is this achieved? Among the various bricks you learned in this tutorial by now, Embedded Wizard also provides bricks, which allows the implementation of your desired functionality. With these bricks, you are flexible to code the behavior of the application. In the canvas area of the composer, click on the round play push button to select it. Now the properties of the widget are revealed in the inspector window. Look there for the button's property onActivate. As you see, the button's property onActivate is actually initialized with the expression onPushButton. This expression in turn addresses the identically named brick, a so-called slot method. At the runtime, when the pushbutton is activated, the button will send a signal to the associated slot method and trigger so its execution. The slot method thus serves as a functioning entity which can be recognized by the beveled edges of the corresponding bricks. Now double-click on the brick on push button to reveal its content. Unlike the bricks you learned before, the content of a slot method is shown in the code editor in the bottom right area of Embedded Wizard. In this example, the implementation of the slot method on push button consists of two lines of code written in Embedded Wizard's Cora, its own object-oriented and platform-independent programming language. The syntax of Cora is very similar to the common languages C, C++, Java, JavaScript, C#. So if you already have experience with one of these languages, you will find this code here comprehensible. After successfully evaluating an if condition, the slot method invokes a method named startBrewing. The method is invoked in the context of a global object, an auto object device, which exists within the unit application. As you remember, at the beginning I have explained that the object device as well as the both accompanying bricks, for example device class, build the interface to the underlying device. When invoking the method, the current value stored in the object horizontal slider is evaluated and passed to the method as a parameter. The value corresponds to the actual position of the coffee strength slider. That's all. For the moment, it is sufficient to understand that startBrewing controls the brewing process in the device. It activates the heater, the water pump, and depending on the value passed in its parameter, it regulates the duration of the brewing. We will analyze its implementation later. It is important to understand that during the code generation, Embedded Wizard evaluates or compiles all the code written in Cora and generates the equivalent and optimized code for the desired target system, for example, ANSI C or JavaScript. There is no runtime interpreter nor any other just-in-time compiler used in the target system. The code is executed natively. Furthermore, Cora is used not only to implement your own application-specific business logic. The entire Mosaic framework, which is the basement of every GUI application, is implemented in Cora. Like in other development systems, when you program an error, the application will not work as expected. To help you finding the cause of the problem, Embedded Wizard integrates a fully functional debugger environment. With it, you can set breakpoints, step through the code, inspect the call stack, variables and objects directly while you test the application in the prototyper window. Let's try the following. In the code editor, click within the first code row so the blinking caret appears there. Then, in the upper area of Embedded Wizard window, click on the tool button Toggle Breakpoint to set a breakpoint at the just clicked code row in the code editor. You can also use the shortcut F9 on your keyboard to achieve the same effect. The breakpoint is indicated by a red circle directly on the left of the affected code row. Now, start the prototype again by using the shortcut Ctrl F5 to test the entire application. In the running prototyper window, click on the play button to activate the brewing process. Now, the slot method on push button is executed, the breakpoint is triggered, and the execution is paused. While the execution is paused, you can see a small green triangle which appears in the code editor. It indicates the next statement to be executed. Additionally, a new window with the title variables is shown. In this window, you can actually see the unique value this, which refers to this object in the context of which the executed method has been invoked. It represents the actual object. By clicking on the small gray triangle on the left of this, you can expand and inspect the values it contains. To continue the execution step by step, click on the tool button Step Over found in the upper area of Embedded Wizard, or use the shortcut F10 on your keyboard to achieve the same effect. Thereupon, the green triangle moves to the next row and the variables window is updated. Besides the above presented variables window, the integrated debugger also provides many other windows you can activate when the prototyping is paused from the menu window. An exception is the window Memory Usage, which can be shown during the complete runtime of the application, which allows you to analyze the RAM footprint of a GUI project. Now, remove the breakpoint again by clicking on the tool button Remove All Breakpoints. Then click on the tool button Continue to resume the application execution. Finally, close the prototype window again.